If you see any wacky camera shots over the next few minutes, please forgive our camera operators because, well, they're not paying a lick of attention to what they're doing right now, right, Jeff and Gary? Yeah, right?
Well, this guy either, for that matter, and in case you're wondering why, because of robots? Do we really need to say more? Here to connect the dots for us, this is 8th grade student at Sussex Academy, Mason Trench, and 5th grade math and science teacher at H.O. Brittingham. This is Mr. Mark Morey joining us this afternoon. Guys, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you.
Oh, and you're also the after-school robotics coach.
Correct.
Right? Okay.
About 3 years now.
So, wow. I really want to talk about this. You guys are getting ready for a big competition this weekend, right?
Yeah.
Yes. This Saturday is the Delmarva Regional Finals for the VEX IQ program. VEX IQ is a robotics program designed for elementary and middle school students. And they design and build robots based on a given game. Every year the game changes, so they have a different task to accomplish. And this is the culmination of this season's work. Where if the top teams who win basically will have the chance to go on to Dallas to compete in the world competition in May. So very exciting.
And Mason, Dallas. That's something you've already done before. So this is nothing new.
Yeah, I mean, I hope to get there again. The first time it was a really good experience. You see people from all over the world. Just teams from every country. And, you know, you see those other teams from the other countries and the things that they bring to worlds. It's just, you don't see that around here.
Yeah.
You enjoy this?
Mm-hmm.
Why?
Yeah. I mean, I like it because you're part of a team and you're also competing with another team. You know, it kind of humbles you. See, you're not doing it by yourself.
Right.
You know, you're one of four. If you mess up, you know, you usually have people, they catch you. And I don't know. I mean, it's like you're 25%. It's not all on you.
And one of the interesting things is it's not like battle bots. They're not fighting each other. It's we kind of coined it as a co-opetition because you're working with another team at the same time to score as many points as you can. So you're working with another team that might not even speak the same language as you.
Oh, wow.
And you have to coordinate how to score as many points as you can together. And there's a language barrier sometimes. So it's just an amazing experience watching these kids get to work with people from all over to accomplish a goal.
Yeah.
So it's an amazing thing.
That's a great life skill. And Mark, can you talk a little bit about the importance of having programs like this one in schools?
STEM, of course, is a huge push right now. And one of the big things that we're accomplishing is pushing girls into STEM fields. And when we started the program, one of the big things at HOB was we had to have as many girls as boys on our team. It was a requirement. We wouldn't start the team without it. And we've actually ended up with 60% girls versus boys, which is amazing. We start them in third and fourth grade. And by fifth grade, typically they're building robots like this. And it's everything involved in the whole engineering process. They're given the task, they've shown the game of what they're gonna do this year. And they have to kind of design and engineer and build it and then realize it didn't work the way they wanted it to. So they have to fix things and go back to redesign until they get exactly what they want to do. So it's just inspiring to see kids who don't have this type of opportunity all the time in this area. Possibly to think about careers in engineering and STEM fields and science and technology. There's a driving component, and of course there's an autonomous and programmed component also, where basically the robot will do everything on its own that they've programmed it to do. And that's a separate part called the skills competition.
Mason, so you don't have much fun with this, do you?
I mean, I like it. I mean, the whole competition thing, it puts a lot of pressure on you sometimes.
Yeah.
So I kind of like practicing better, to be honest. It's weird. You know, like once you get a team, you work with them for like a couple months, you start to like be kind of a family.
Yeah.
Especially because like you get a lot of teams usually from like the same club, kind of. And they all kind of work together, like pass ideas around. You really start to like, you're family really.
Wow.
That's why I like it.
And you say you like the practice. Is it one of those things where you learn from failures?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Like, you take your robot, you'll probably start with something really basic at the beginning, and then as you practice with it more, you'll get something better, and then by the time you get up to the competition, you'll usually have something pretty good.
So Mark, what's it like, that light bulb moment when you see them get it?
Oh, it's amazing. It's amazing. And one of the things with the VEX program is it's designed to be student driven. So as much as we want to kind of get in there ourselves and play,
right.
Sometimes we have to step back and let them kind of figure out what's going wrong, or we can guide them, but we can't build it for them. So we can give them advice, We can talk to things about why gear ratios are important, how to make your robot faster by changing your gear ratios and things like that, or make it stronger so it can lift itself off the ground, which is one of the components of this year's game. But it's very student-driven, and just let them do that.
All right. Well, we are so happy that you brought these in here. Of course, you have your competition coming up this weekend. Fascinating stuff, but coming up next, Leah's on deck, and she's getting a lesson on how these bad boys work. We'll be right back.
Now, we heard about how incredible the robotics program is, but like Lisa said before the break, it's time to see how these bad boys work. It's time for the fun stuff. And I've got Mason. How do these things work? Because I was not a robotics kid.
it's basically like any video game you've played. You
okay.
Know? If you go push these two forward, you go forward. Uh-huh. Both backwards, you're backwards. If you push this one forward, you're going to go right. And if you push this one forward, you're going to go left.
Uh-huh.
And so the goal is to capture these, to score them. So to do that, you drive up on them, uh-huh. and you lift this up, and then you clamp down on it. And then you control this. You can drive it around.
How do you lift the arms up?
So right here,
oh, okay.
this button right here, if you press up on it, it'll go up. You go down, it'll go down. You can drive over them. And then it can't get out.
Cool. So is this one of the tasks in the competition?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Want to give it a try? All right, so that was, whoops. Yep, this one and these.
Yep.
Got it. Woo! Oh my gosh, one of the best, hooray! I'm a pro. I love it. So that competition is coming up this weekend, right?
Yep.
You guys ready?
We should be.
As ready as you will be.
Yeah.
Awesome. Now we got to see the small robot in action. It's time to talk about the big guy. So tell me a little bit, Mason, how this is all put together, because there's a lot of pieces here and I wouldn't even know where to start.
So to hang, since this one's a little bit heavier, it uses small to big gear ratio right here to make it a little bit stronger.
Okay.
To lift up the extra weight. And then also, this one can shoot the balls out
Ooh.
To score more points.
Fun.
So you would use this impeller to uh-huh. suck it up into this flywheel,
uh-huh.
and that's gonna shoot it out.
Woo! I love it. How much time did this take to put together?
A while.
Many, many hours.
Yeah.
Got it.
This one's also, it drives a little bit more controlled.
Uh-huh.
Because as you can see, kind of like also right here, so this has more of like a big to small gear ratio right uh-huh. here. Just so this goes faster, so it can shoot them out faster.
Okay. Well, Mason, thank you so much for breaking this down and explaining it to me. Good luck next weekend. It's going to be so much fun.
Yeah, thank you.
You're welcome.